Now, next point is higher education for persons with special needs. In that, the Persons with Disability Act 1995 indicates that disabled persons should have access to education at all levels. Though service to disabled children in India is more than 100 years old, the coverage of these children in the formal school system is not even 5%. The report of Manpower Development published by the Rehabilitation Council of India reveals that more than 1 lakh teachers will be needed in the next 10 years to cater the educational needs of disabled children in the school. Bachelor's and master's level teacher programs are needed for preparing teachers to help disabled children realize the objective of education for all. The University Grant Commission will support selected university departments and colleges of education in the country to offer special education with financial assistance available under the program of integrated education for disabled children by the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, or within the available resources of the UGC. The UGC has started the scheme of assistance to universities, colleges to facilitate teacher preparation in special education and higher education for persons with special needs during the 9-5-year plan. Keeping in view the needs to be provide special education programs as well as infrastructure to differently abled persons. The infrastructure needs to be designed in a manner to enable them to easily access classrooms, laboratories, toilets, etc. Objectives. The objectives of the scheme are as follows. First one, to encourage universities, colleges of education in the country to promote teacher preparation programs in the field of special education. Then to provide equal educational opportunities to disabled persons in higher education institutions. Then to create awareness among the functionaries of higher education about the specific educational needs of persons with disability. And to equip higher education institution with the facilities to provide access to the disabled persons. To provide appropriate financial assistance to disabled individuals to increase their sustainability in higher education. Then to explore suitable placement opportunities for educated disabled graduates in public as well as private sector enterprises. To monitor the implementation of all existing and future legislation and policies pertaining to higher education of persons with disabilities. This scheme is aimed particularly at providing assistance to universities, colleges of education to start teacher preparation courses in special education at the B.Ed, M.Ed level and creating appropriate facilities for persons with special needs in higher education. Eligibility condition. College offering a special education course at B.Ed and M.Ed level will be given assistance as per the following conditions. The college university department should have the approval of the Rehabilitation Council of India for starting the concerned teacher preparation program in special education. The college should have a model school where disabled children are admitted. In the absence of its own model school, the college should produce in writing the acceptance of a special or integrated school in the vicinity to function as a model school. Again, the college should have a minimum of 5 years of experience in running B.Ed level teacher preparation course. The university or college applying for grant for any one of the activities of this scheme should have enrolled a minimum of 10 disabled persons including physically handicapped, mentally retarded and visually impaired in the academic year. The university college should have constituted an expert committee involving faculty members from the university experts in the field and persons with disability themselves. The committee should meet at least once a year to review the activities related to the concerned scheme. Institutions applying for the scheme should have been approved by the UGC under the sections 2F and 12B. For financial assistance to the university departments and colleges of education will be given by the UGC as per the following norms. First norm is the institution must have one professor or one reader and two lecturers to run a B.Ed. course and one professor, one reader and three lecturers for the M.Ed. course in special education in any one of the specific disabilities area with a minimum of 20 students and the maximum of 30. Assistance from the UGC will be for the 10th plan period and the implementing institute should give an undertaking that it will continue the course with the assistance of the state government or generate its own resources to meet the expenditure of the course after the plan. The implementing institute should also provide extension services to the special schools and integrated schools to strengthen the quality of the special education in those settings. In addition to the salary grant, the UGC will provide a maximum of rupees 1 lakh per year per institute towards purchase of books, journals, special aids and appliances for its special education teacher preparation course. A midterm evaluation may be carried out by the UGC. Provision of facilities. This scheme has three components. They are enumerated as follows. First is establishment of special units for differently abled persons in university or colleges. It is a fact that universities and colleges are not fully aware of the needs of differently abled persons in higher education. In order to develop awareness in the higher education system and also to provide necessary guidance and counseling to the differently abled person, it is proposed to establish special units in university and colleges in the country. The functions of this unit will be to facilitate admission of persons with disability, then provide guidance and counseling to differently abled individuals, create awareness about the need of person with disabilities and other general issue concerning disabilities, and assist disabled graduates to gain successful employment in the public as well as private sector. The special unit will be coordinated by the faculty member to be nominated by the head of the institution. He or she will work as an honorary coordinator for which a token honorarium of 3000 per month will be paid. Then there is also a provision for the appointment of one honorary placement officer for the special unit from amongst the faculty members of the university, and he or she will be paid a token honorarium of 2000 rupees per month. The coordinator and the placement officer will be assisted by a team of three student volunteers who will be paid a stipend of 1000 rupees each per month. Honorarium for the all categories will be paid from the date of joining. Then the unit will also have a budgetary provision of 30,000 per annum towards programs, stationery, contingency, etc. for efficient and independent functioning in order to achieve its objective. The disability unit will also be involved in arranging awareness program on disability within the institutions and also in other higher education institutes in their respective states. A budgetary provision of rupees 20,000 per unit per year will be made by the UGC.